Hello, Crypto Fam. Tech Lead's brother here. Recently, I made a cameo on one of my brother's videos. Needless to say, my bro gets a lot more views than I do. In an earlier video, I talked about how we might go about rewriting Ruby mode in terms of tree sitter. Well, thanks to the good people at NeoVim, from whom I've cribbed their indentation algorithm, tree sitter major modes are now a thing. You'll recall Emacs' current syntactic parser, something called parse partial s expression state, or PPSS. The word partial means it parses the immediate vicinity of your cursor and not the whole buffer. S expression state gives away the fact that the engine was originally written to parse ELISP and subsequently had to be extended for other languages like C. As you can imagine, that extending was easier for Lispy languages, but required brutal regular expressions for others. But check it out. Thanks to Mr. Brunsfeld and GitHub, under whose employ some of TreeSitter was developed, we can get this monkey off our backs. Suppose there's this awesome new language that's come into the world, but alas, chose a terrible two-letter name, G-O. To get it going in Emacs, we create a treesittergomo.el. First, we require treesitter prog mode, which is a major mode that derives from fundamental mode, much in the way that prog mode derived from fundamental mode. Then define derived mode, treesittergomode, from treesitter prog mode, and give it a sensible name like Golang. Then we provide tree sitter go mode. And that is all for the major mode. I'll use -q to show that I'm not cheating. Now, tree sitter go mode still does not know where its tree sitter grammar resides. This we resolve by customizing an option called tree sitter mode a list. We insert a new entry, tree sitter go mode, and have it map to the tree sitter grammar go. Okay, now we open a file that's written in go and do meta x tree sitter go mode. We see the syntax highlighting. So we talked in an earlier video about what syntactic programming modes offer, which is three things: syntactic highlighting, basic motion, and indentation. So for basic motion, tree sitter has a fine-grained understanding of what the parse tree looks like. So if I do, control meta A goes to the beginning of the function. So tree sitter understands what a function looks like in Go, and control meta E takes you to the end of the function. There's also control meta F, which sort of iterates across siblings in the parse tree going sideways. So if I do control meta F, it'll iterate sideways over the parse tree. Control meta B goes the other way, goes left, previous siblings. And finally, indentation. So if I manage to screw up the indentation, I'll do this intentionally. Let's see. I'll just mess this up. Okay, and then I do control space, which is select region. I do control meta F, which is the entire function. And then I indent region. For me, it's escape control backslash. That fixes up all the indentation.